like a morning star, a setting sun or rolling waves at sea, a gentle breeze or lightning in a storm, a dancing dream of all eternity. The sand was shimmering in the morning light, and dancing off the dew so far away. The night held the music so sweet, so long, and there we lay until the break of day. We woke that morning at the onward call. A garment brightened up our hood as full. The sun was rising in the eastern sky, just as we set out to the desert's cry. Smaller as we rode away on earth that tells of many passing days, the months of peace on the years of war, the lives of love and all the lives of fears. The river beds all etched in stone, and up the muddy mountain seven moon, beyond the valleys in the searing heat, until we reach the caravanserai. What is this life that pulls me far away? What is that home where we cannot reside? What is that quest that pulls me on the road? My heart is full when you are by my side. Calling you.
Thank you. Steve. a vision before me. We left the music behind as the dance carried on, as we stole away to the seashore. We smelled the brine, felt the wind in our hair, and we sang as you passed. Suddenly I knew that you'd have to go. Your world was not mine, your eyes told me so. Yes, it was that I felt the crossroads of time, and I wondered why. As we cast our gaze on the trembling sea, a vision came on me of thundering hoofs and beating wings and clouds above. As you turned to go, I heard you call my name. You were like a bird in a cage, spreading its wings to fly. The always are lost, you sang as you flew. Calling me home.
Thank you. To the lodge in the echoing night, nearer came the time. Some of those who emigrated came to Canada on timber ships, particularly to a quarantine station off of Quebec City called Gros Isle. And in the early 1980s, I was working on a one-woman musical production based on the Irish coming to Canada at that time. I never finished it, but these next two melodies come from that project. They're called the Emigration Tune. She, in turn, was much more interested in the politics at the time and was in love with a man called John McBride, and not so much with W.B. Yeats. So this next poem, which is a Yeats poem and set by someone to music over 100 years ago, I often think that perhaps Yeats had Maud Gonne in mind when he wrote it. It's a piece called Down by the Sally Gardens. application to make in the event that it's necessary. Many people believe that I come from Ireland, but in actual fact, I grew up in the middle of the Canadian prairies. But I took a keen interest in the Celtic music once I heard it. Like many people around the world, have recognized there's something quite infectious in that music. This is also the moment that I'd like to take the opportunity to introduce you to the people that I have a very, very great pleasure of sharing the stage with each night. It is an extraordinary thing to work with such talented individuals. So beginning on my left-hand side, up on pipes, clarinet, whistle and flute, Mr. Ian Parker. Dudley Phillips. On drums and percussion, Mr. Roy Dodds. On guitars and bouzouki, Mr. Tony McManus. Guitars and oud, Mr. Brian Hughes. On cello, Miss Caroline Lavelle.